Hello, this is Dr. Uday Thanawala, a gynecologist and obstetrician practicing in Vashi, New Bombay. Today we'll speak about why is it important for a pregnant woman to have a blood sugar range normal. Now, if the woman's blood sugar is high, it has effect on the fetus. This effect on the fetus is There could be a short-term effect that is during the pregnancy. The baby puts on much more weight than normal. There's much more fluid around the baby, which can lead to pregnancy complications. This baby, when it's born, it can have problems to maintain the blood sugar after birth. So the babies require an ICU and special care after birth. But the most dreaded of these complications is what is known as genetic programming, which happens in these fetuses. There's a concept of fetal origin of adult disease. Means fetuses which are exposed to a high sugar level in uterus, ultimately their pancreas gets programmed, and these babies then cannot produce the amount of insulin in adult life, and they in their adult life become diabetics. What I'm trying to say is that we are passing on the disease of diabetes to the next generation if the pregnant woman doesn't control the sugar, if it is abnormal. Now, you'll ask me what is the incidence of a pregnant woman getting diabetes. Now, out of 100 women, around 12 to 15%, that is 12 to 15, will turn out to be gestational diabetics. How do you test for them? Well, we test for them when we come into first contact with them. That is, could be in the first trimester, in the first 3 months. But it's very important to test for them again, even if they are negative, between 24 to 28 weeks, because 6 to 7 months is the time when the pregnancy hormones bring about changes in the woman's metabolism, and these women can become diabetics at that particular stage. So two tests are recommended in pregnancy, one in the first contact and another one at 24 to 26 weeks. Which is the test which we do? Now, generally the test which is done is a glucose challenge test. There are multiple varieties available or recommended all over the world, but in the Indian conditions, what suits us best is what is known as the dipsy test. Now, this dipsy test is a test where a woman is given 75 grams glucose in half a glass of water, and after 2 hours, blood is tested for the blood sugar, and if it is 140, they are just labeled as diabetics. We do not insist that the woman should be fasting. She can come in the non-fasting state. We give them a glucose packet. They drink the glucose, and after 2 hours, they can get their blood tested, even by a glucometer in the other rural areas or PHCs where they don't have facilities or for laboratory. The way we do it in our clinic is we have an anhydrous glucose packet available. We give it to them in the previous visit, say at 20, 22 weeks, and say, okay, when you come next, drink this glucose packet, irrespective of the last meal. After drinking the packet, don't eat or drink anything. And after 2 hours, give your blood to the laboratory for the glucose test. It is as simple as that. If the level comes above 140, that means they cannot metabolize the sugar to the required level, and they have got glucose intolerance or gestational diabetes. Now, once you pick up as a gestational diabetes, or you know that your sugar level is going high with this glucose thing, and it's remaining high after every meal, then it is important to control it so that the effects are not passed on to the baby. Control is not difficult. 90% of the gestational diabetes women are controlled only on a diet and exercise. You have to go to a dietitian, get a proper diet chart made, eat sensibly, be aware of the sugar, and you have to do some exercise to get it under control. If that doesn't work, and you don't get your fasting levels down to 90, and your post meal, that is 2 hours after every meal, if your level is not down to 120, then you may require drugs. And today you've got oral drugs like metformin available easily, well tolerated, and can bring down the sugar level very safely. If that also doesn't work, then maybe you have to go on to insulin, and you have to see a physician for that. But all in all, it is important to get the sugars well under control if you are a gestational diabetic, so that the bad effects of this high sugar are not passed on to the baby. We have had young, thin-looking women who also have abnormal sugar. So all women need to be tested. It is initially it was said that women who have got a previous history of stillbirth or obese women, they are, or elderly women need to be tested for sugar. But now the whole concept has changed, and now what is recommended is universal screening, and all women need to be screened. So get a good screening in your pregnancy done. Get your sugar tested twice, first at the first contact and then again at around 6 to 7 months, to make sure that you don't have gestational diabetes. And if you have gestational diabetes, please take care and maintain the blood sugar levels to 90 fasting and 120 postprandial, so that you get a good outcome in pregnancy. And if you maintain these sugar levels, your pregnancy will proceed as a normal pregnancy with no other interference required, and your baby will do very well. So when it comes to passing karma down, what we say in the Hindu mythology, that the baby gets a lot of karma in the uterus, so pass on all the good karmas to the baby and not the diabetes.